Hello everybody, myself Dr. Garg. Today we are talking about the new method for solving the unconstrained optimization problem, and the method is known as the Hook-Jeeves method. It is also called as the pattern search method. So myself Garg, I am working in the School of Mathematics. If there is any doubt in this video, you can contact me either through my email ID, through my website, or through my channel still. So all of you know that there are the several methods for solving the unconstrained optimization problem, and which are discretized into the two parts are there. One is without the derivative, that is called as the zeroth order, or it is also known as the direct search method, while the other are based on the gradient methods are there, that is with the help of their derivatives. So which are and there are the several methods which are classified in these two categories are there. So right now we are discuss about this, that is a Hook-Jeeves method. On the other hand, regarding the gradient search method, we have already covered the steepest descent, Fletcher Reeves. It is also called as the conjugate gradient method, Newton's method, and so on. So if you want to wish to learn this method again, so you can follow the last videos of my through my channel, and these are the certain links are there. So now let's start with the Hook-Jeeves method. It is called as the pattern search also. Why we call as the pattern search? So we will see, because it follows some pattern and then try to search for the new point P. So this Hook-Jeeves method is basically divided into the two moves are there. The first move is also is called as the exploratory move, and second is called as the pattern P. The task of this exploratory move is to find the best point in the vicinity of the current point P. So suppose you have at this point initial, then either you can move in this side or on this side or on this side, and then so on, be at any point of there. So this direction will tell us about the through the exploratory move. Once you find the new best point with the help of this algorithm, then we will try to jump in the direction of their change. So that is in what direction we can find the best change, that is decided with the help of the pattern move. So if it is better, then we will continue, otherwise we will reduce the size of this exploratory move. So how you reduce the size, that will be covered in the couple of slides are there. So what we'll do is that, suppose my task is to minimize the function f. So what we do in the exploratory move is, instead of minimizing the function f through all the variables, I just start firstly with the x1. So I just firstly minimize this f with the help of the x1. We will find the best position of the x1, which minimize the f. Then we will move on the x2. Once we find the minimum of the x1, then we will find x2, and then so on up to n. That is, we will search the direction point wise are there. So what we will do is, suppose initially x1 is a point, then we will perturb the x1, that is x1 variables, in either on the right hand side with some increment and on the left hand side with some increment. So in the exploratory move, only one direction is chosen. So initially say I say x1. If you choose x2, then what it means, x2 plus delta x2, x2 minus delta x2. So remember that only one direction is chosen at a time. So with the increment this. So after that we find this. So what is the coordinate of this point is, x is perturbed while x2, x3 and all others are remain same. So this is the point. And while this is x2 up to the xn, and these are x1 plus this, and x2 up to the xn. So means we have to perturb only the x1 initially. So once we get three different points are there, then we will evaluate the function f at these points are there. So we will calculate the function at these points. So say f of negative, this is a negative sign, this is the f original, and say this is the f positive sides are there. And since my function is a minimization, we have to preserve the best value are there. So save the best value at these three points are there. So assume that the best values occur at this. Okay. So it means the x1 direction is minimizing in terms of x1 plus of delta x1b. Now we will do the same thing for the x2. So what will happen in x2 is, we will move in this as well as in this. So this point is x1 is remains same. So x2 plus delta x2. Here is my x2, and here is x2 minus delta x2. So what is the coordinate of this point is, here x1 is nothing but the x1 plus delta x1, x2 is here, while x3 up to xn remains same, similarly for here. and then again find their function value at these points, and then choose the minimum one b, and then go for the third and then solve. So once we'll find all these, that we will explain also in the numerical examples are there. So say initially are there, so after the two, say for example function is there, so we reach at this point b. So these are the exploratory search along the coordinate axis are there. So this is x1 direction, this is x2 direction. Once you reach at here, say for example my function is x1 and x2 are there, so it means we have to stop here. So then the next move, that is a pattern search. So you start from here and the new point is A. So you will find the direction in this way, that is called as the pattern move. That is, you have to find the search direction S. So how you find the search direction is, this is nothing but A minus X2. That is the direction is there. Sorry, A minus X1. A minus X1. Once you find this direction, then we will find the new point X2 by using the usual rule P. This plus lambda times of the S, and we will find this lambda is there. Similarly, once we find the new point X2, then again we will move on this side. This is nothing but my X. Now this X2 is the new point, so we will move on this. And here is a negative sign, then move and so on. So if you get new point here, now this is my new search direction. Now the new search direction is A minus X2. And then find the new point as X3. So what is, how do you find the X3 is this. And so on. Okay. So I will explain all the mechanism with the help of the two numerical examples, and then we will cover these slides again. So my task is to minimize this function f starting from the initial point b. So take the increment as a point 8b. So it means we are starting at this point 0, 0b. So what we do is, initially we perturb x1 in the direction of the x1 coordinate. So what we do is, firstly is the exploratory move b. So firstly move in the x1 direction. So x1 is my 0, 0, perturb in terms of the, now since there are the only two coordinates, x1, x2, so we perturb this on the left hand side or on the right hand side b, and the right hand side b. So x1 plus delta x1, b is x1 minus delta x1, and since what is the coordinate of the x2 is here is 0, so it will be a 0. So what is the value of here is this one. Now calculate the function value. So what is the, my function value is this. Calculate the function value at the point A, X1 and A, B, X1 and A. So calculate the B, X1 and A, the function value this. So you will get F of A is 0.48, 0, 2.08. And my task is to minimize the function. So which is the minimum is this. Okay, the function value this is. So select the minimum point. So minimum point is X1. So it means we have to delete the rest values are there. So what we'll get is only this point. Okay, so that's the end of the, no, so that's the end of the exploratory move in the direction of the x1. Now move in the direction of the x2b. So now move direction of the x2 is here in this side. So what are the coordinate of this is 0, 0. So move in there. So x2 plus delta x2 and x2 minus delta x2b, and the coordinate of x1 is 0b. So you will get this and this, and calculate the function value. You will get 1.440 minus 0 points, and again my task is to minimize the function. So which one is minimum is this. A is a minimum, so it means you start from here x1, reach at the point A. So in the next line you have to reach this one. So that since there are only two coordinates are there, x1 and x2, so it means my exploratory move is over. And check whether A is equal to x1, and since there is no, since A is not equal to x1, so we will move into the pattern. Okay, if in certain case, if A is equal to x1, it means if I say this value is say plus, so what is the minimum is 0. Okay, so what is the meaning is, in the next phase, then there is only x1 is there. So it means we are unable to find the new point. So if in that case, if A is equal to x1, then what will we do is, remember that if A is equal to x1, then we will reduce the increments delta xi. Initially in this case is, we have taken the point x1 as a delta x2, point x2 as again as a by alpha. Alpha can be chosen anyone, but preferably it will be 2. Okay, so we'll be, so if the new point is remain the same, then we will choose the new deltas are 0.4, 0.4, and then move the exploratory moves again. Anyhow, since A is not equal to X2, so we will start on the pattern move. There are the two steps are there. firstly find the patron direction, that is this. So what is the patron direction? Is s. So we are moving in this side, a minus x1. So what is the coordinate of a? Is 0, 0.8. x1 is nothing but 0, 0, so the s1 is here. Now based on this s1, we will find the new point x2 by using a plus lambda x. So since I have found the new point as a, so this plus lambda times s, so you will get this. So this is my point of x1, this is my point of x2, and the unknown parameter is lambda. And the task of lambda is in all the kinds of the unconstrained problem is to find the optimal length lambda, which will minimize the function at a point x2. So how you find the lambda is, there are the two methods. So first method is, since the point is give this, you can substitute this value in directly in this equation. Means x1 is nothing but my 0, this is my x2. So you can substitute this value in here, and after simplify you will get this equation. And my task is to minimize the function. So what is the rule of the minimization? Is first derivative is 0 and second derivative must be greater than 0. So we will find that for the minimization, first derivative must be 0. So after solving you will get this. Okay, and second derivative at this point is 1.28 and it is greater than 0. So it means this is minimum. So substitute this value in here, you will get the new point as this one. Okay, so this is the first method to calculate the value of the lambda. Otherwise, for the second method, if the function is quadratic, then only you can use this easiest method. Otherwise, follow always this one. So since my function is quadratic, okay, so I can prefer to use this one. So what is this method is, you can find the value of lambda directly by here. What is the del of f? Is nothing but the gradient. Okay, so what is the gradient of f? Is since my f is there, so what is the gradient of with respect to x1? This is 1 plus 4x1 plus of 2x2. And what is the gradient with respect to x2? This is minus 1 plus 2x1 plus 2x2. So this is my gradient. And h, s we have already calculated that. And what is the h? Is Hessian matrix, which are calculated here. That is the f with respect to x1 2 times, and then so on. And s we have here. So substitute this value in this equation. So firstly we need the del of f at the point. So since my point is a, so firstly you have to calculate the gradient at the point a. So at the point a, the gradient will be, look at that, x1 is 0, so x2 is 0.8, so 1.6 plus 1 is 2.6. so substitute this value in this equation. So what will happen is, look at that, 2.6, 0.6. okay, so look at this is a transpose. What is the s? Is my 0, 0.8. what is s? Is 0, 0. You have to make dimension carefully. So 4 2 2 and 2, and s is 0, 0.8. So what is that? This is 0.48 divided by, and so on. So after solving this, you will get this value. And look at that, the values remain the same. So this is the easiest way to calculate it. So once we know that, this is the point. Okay, so look at that. Where is the point lies? This side. Why? Because the lambda is negative. Okay, so this is the first iteration complete. So now the new point is this. So check whether this point is optimal or not. So how to check the optimality? That is, the gradient is 0 or not. So at the x2 we have find the gradient value is non-zero, so it means this is not an optimal. So we will move on the second point. So since initially we are here, now reach at this point. Now again move on the exploratory phase, that is this and this. So we will start here again. So since this is the x2 is there, so x, now this is my x1. So x1 plus delta x1, x1 minus delta x1. So at these two points are there, calculate the function value. And since the minimum is occurring at which point is there, this is my minimum. So it means we have start from here, reach at this point. So this is the line. Okay, so look at that, x2 to b. Now in the direction of, now at this point, what is the coordinate of b? Is my 0 point, minus 0.8 and 0.5. now you have to find the x2 plus delta 2, x2 minus delta 2. So since x1 is remain same, for the b coordinate is minus 0.8, so x2 plus delta x2, x2 minus delta x2. So you will get these two points, and the function value at these points are this one. So which one is minimum is this value here. Okay, so it means the new point is reached at the point A and you start from the x2. So what is the line final is there? This one. So since A is not equal to x2 because the coordinate of A is my minus 0.8 and 1.3 and the x2 is 0.5. So they are not equal. So we will move on to the pattern move. So how to find the pattern move is we will find the search direction firstly. Now the new point is A. Initial point in this iteration is x2. So A minus x2. Find the new point x3. That is with the help of A plus lambda x. Okay, so A is my nothing but this. Lambda I just need to calculate. S is my this one. And lambda is again we have to find this. Since function is again quadratic, so I have to use this equation. So gradient, calculate the gradient value at this point. So what will we do is at this point, lambda is gradient is this. So after substituting this value in these equations, we will get lambda is minus 0.25. So substitute this lambda in here. So the new point x3 is calculated as this one. Minus 1.5. So now check whether this point is optimal or not. So at this x3, you have to substitute this value as here to check gradient value. Since it is 0, so what is the gradient? 0 means that is the slope is parallel to the x-axis. So it means this is my optimal one. So we have to stop here. So this is a simple working of this Hooke-Jeeves method is there. So what is the brief summary of that is you have to move direction wise x1, x2, one at a time. In the pattern phase, find the search direction, calculate the lambda if it is quadratic by using this, otherwise substitute the value and then check for the optimality. So this is one of the simplest method to find their optimal point in the Hooke-Jeeves method out there. So this is again what is the exploratory move there. So look at that. What is that we have seen in the pattern movies? Initially, you start from here, find the new point. Okay, so this is the search direction S, this is A minus x1, then find the new point as a x2. Similarly, once you find the new point x2, again move on this side. Okay, again you have to move on this or this, and if minimum occurs at this, then find the this and this. So if you get this new point here, search direction is this A minus x2. Find the new point x3 and then move on. Okay, so this is a very simple method. You can easily try solve the few problems are there. So I just give you the 5 exercises for you. Okay, so there are answers are also given to you. So you can try yourself. If there is still any doubt, you can contact me at any time through any of the mode. Best of luck, students.